Modern medicine is great, but a lot of it is misleading. From braces to colon issues to sleep apnea, the list goes on. Modern civilization has taken us away from the natural human habits, which allow our bodies to function at an optimal level. A great example of this is a toilet. Humans are designed to squat to release, not to sit. Sitting is causing a huge list of issues, and you never hit a squat instead of to sit. Sitting on the toilet strains your colon, making it harder to release, whereas squatting expands your colon, making it easier. Squatting is more important than a high-fiber diet. The strain on your colon from sitting on the toilet is causing things like constipation, hemorrhoids, diverticulitis disease, and colon or colorectal cancer, which is the second highest for cancer deaths in Australia. Let's take a look at diverticulitis disease. An inflammation or infection of the pouch is formed in the colon. 500,000 cases per year in Australia. Treatment from medical professionals advised can last several days or weeks. The exact cause is not known. Due to lack of fiber intake in the food, stool becomes harder and it makes it difficult to move in the colon. This leads to pressure on the pouch. Symptoms of diverticulitis are sudden abdominal pain, tenderness, vomiting, nausea, constipation, and bloating. Antibiotics and over-the-counter painkillers are available to treat diverticulitis. Treatments. Medication, antibiotics to reduce multiplications of infectious bacteria and metabolic activity of gas-causing bacteria. Procedures, primary bowel resection with colostomy. Causes, low-fiber diet is considered as the cause of diverticulitis. Low-fiber diet puts pressure on the colon to push a stool out, resulting in lodging of stool matter in the divicula, which leads to infection. About half of patients with complications with their divicula will need surgery. As I mentioned before, the same article stated the cause is not completely known as it's only considered low-fiber diet is to blame. However, if it is pressure on the colon that is forming these pouches, wouldn't a relaxed, expanded colon be a major benefit? In the wild, humans couldn't always count on getting lots of fiber into their diet, but they could always count on an expanded colon. Low-fiber diet is not entirely to blame. Sitting to release is a real cause. Why is this not common knowledge? Because, why fix the cause when you can have a sick patient that constantly comes back? If you're still not convinced modern medicine is profiting off our illness, don't you think it's strange how we know how to perform all these crazy colon surgeries, yet we don't know how we can get shit to pass through our colon correctly? Crooked teeth is also a lie, but people are profiting from it, and for some reason the true information has been kept hidden. Mewing was founded by John Mew in 1966. The jaws of our direct human ancestors almost always grew correctly until we changed our lifestyles about 10,000 years ago and started to eat much softer foods. Later on, we started to live indoors, cook frequently using utensils, gain blocked noses from allergies, and change infant feeding methods, less time breastfeeding, and introduced of soft weaning foods. The soft food weakened our jaw muscles, the indoor living encouraged allergies, while early weaning created abnormal tongue habits, and orthotropists believe that these distort the jaws and teeth. Mewing is a practice to keep the tongue to sit at the roof of the mouth and to maintain habits such as keeping your mouth closed while chewing and breathing through your nose. By doing this, our face develops as nature intended, straight teeth, forward bottom jaw. John Mew has evidence to support these claims. However, the most important thing is to ask yourself, why the fuck would humans have crooked teeth? Wouldn't that stunt our ability to survive? Not only does this practice improve teeth, but it also improves facial development for a better looking face. Even if you don't have crooked teeth, please check out John and Mike Mew's work. Their YouTube and website is called Orthotropist. Spread the message, there will be a link in the description. It's not just crooked teeth that mewing can help. Sleep apnea is also caused by poor facial posture. Again, why the fuck would humans have sleep apnea? Wouldn't that stunt our ability to survive? What's happening is that poor facial posture is bringing the bottom jaw and tongue back, restricting the airways. Sleep apnea occurs usually when the tongue restricts the airway, but by practicing mewing, it brings the bottom jaw forward, allowing for more space for airflow. While sleep apnea may not kill you, it is estimated it affects 22 million Americans, which is inhibiting their ability to get a good night's sleep. Lack of oxygen to the brain can also damage it. So they go to the doctor about feeling fatigue or just drink more coffee, which is leading to more and more issues, more and more money, and the machine keeps turning over cash. This is what mainstream treatment will have you led to believe. The most widely used and most successful treatments for moderate and severe sleep apnea in adults is one or another of the various positive airway pressure machines. More detail on the types of PAP machine is available here. Other treatments include weight loss, avoiding sleeping on one's back, nighttime mandibular advancement devices that push a lower jaw or the tongue forward, and a variety of surgical procedures. The treatment options are described in greater detail and evaluated here. Let's take a look at the positive airway pressure machine, because this is heaps accessible in the wild. Nature doesn't intend for us to have all these problems. We are animals, and our bodies function perfectly. I'm pretty sure the king of the jungle could get a good night's sleep, otherwise we would have been killed off. We fought off the Neanderthals, hunted the woolly mammoth, but for some reason we can't get a good night's sleep. I guarantee you there is better methods of treatment out there. The information is circulating, but it is kept hidden from the public. We treat depression with some of the most abused drugs. Opioids are killing more people than any street drug. So many things are being treated, not cured. Eat a healthy diet, practice getting in cold water. Inflammation is no longer a problem. And get plenty of exercise, squat when you shit, check out orthotropics on YouTube, and do your research every time you are prescribed medication. If there is a natural alternative, it would be much better, I guarantee you. And all else hell, it's never ever coming through.